We are living in a golden age of documentaries, thanks to Netflix and Amazon. One of the greatest documentaries out there is Veducated. It tells the story of three people who were destroying their lives, eating processed food, meat, and dairy. Over a six-week period, they are converted to veganism. Veducated is an award-winning guerrilla-style documentary following three meat and cheese-loving New Yorkers who adopt a vegan diet for 6 weeks. I cannot recommend this movie enough because all of us should be on a vegan diet, and we all know we should, and we're afraid of it because we think it's too hard. It's not. Joining us is the director of Veducated, Marissa Miller. Hello, Marissa Miller.
Hi.
It's Marissa Wolfson Miller, correct?
It's actually Marissa Miller Wolfson.
Veducated is a delightful movie. It's so much fun. You can stream it on Netflix, buy it, get it, watch it, become a vegan. I wanted to do an update on the three people who you converted to veganism or tried to convert to veganism. It's been 2 or 3 years, so I'm curious, especially about the psychiatrist. But first, you are pregnant with your second child.
I know. How did that happen? I mean, I know how that happened, but it's crazy. You know, one has different phases in life, and ha-ha, that's funny. This is where I am now.
All right, let me ask you about your appetite.
Yeah.
You are married to a man who is a vegan?
He's mostly vegan. You know what? He's vegan-ish. He's hardcore into animal protection, but he's not like a purist about it. So if he's a corporate lawyer by day, and he's a animal law professor and animals and public policy professor by night, and he also counsels, you know, Mercy for Animals and all these other great organizations. But if he's in a boardroom and there's a cookie, he'll eat the cookie. Whereas I'm like, no.
So he eats, occasionally he'll have dairy.
Yeah.
But he wouldn't eat chicken or fish.
He hasn't had a farmed animal. He hasn't had a land animal in like 30 years or something.
And I know that our meat eaters out there are going to say, well, he's a corporate lawyer. He's not a director of documentaries. He needs all his brain power. So, of course, occasionally he's going to eat dairy products because the brain can't live on plant food alone.
It has nothing to do with brain power. It has more to do with willpower or lack thereof.
What do you say to our listeners who eat meat, other than shame on you? What do you say to them if they're thinking, I need dairy, I need meat for my brain?
For your brain. That's interesting.
So you're married to a corporate lawyer. He's a professor. Yeah. He has tremendous brain power, even though for 30 years he rarely has dairy products.
That's true. And actually, if you think about, this is kind of going all over the place. When I told my dad that we're raising our kid vegan, he got, you know, concerned. I mean, actually, his friends got concerned. Like, well, the baby needs fish to
You're from Indiana.
Yeah. So there were no vegans in Indiana growing up, you know, for me, that I knew of. And this is all kind of new to my dad and my community and all that. But anyway, they said, you know, this child needs to eat, you know, at least fish. If, you know, the child isn't having meat or dairy, you know, at least fish because of the omega-3s. And I had to point out to my dad, you know, there are so many, like, we would consider, like, overachieving, highly intellectual, like, super, super smart kids. Like, the kids in my school who kicked our butts and ruined the grading curve were not eating dairy. They weren't eating, you know, there were a lot of the Indian kids who grew up on a vegetarian diet, you know, kids of immigrants. They never ate fish, you know. They didn't eat meat. Or, you know, there was a Vietnamese girl who she was lactose intolerant. She couldn't drink milk. And, you know, she kicked our butts. So I was just reminding my dad of that. He was like, oh, good point. There, you know, throughout history, there have been whole populations who have eschewed, you know, this or that thing that we consider absolutely essential for survival.
Is there enough
to their benefit?
Is there enough to live on if you just eat rice and beans? What would you be lacking if all you lived on were rice and beans?
If all you live on is any two things, you're lacking.
Okay. What vitamins? Bs, B12s? What do you need?
So B12 is pretty much the only vitamin that you don't get on a vegan diet, you know, if you don't eat foods that are fortified with it, or a vitamin.